Hi, everyone. Thanks for joining me. I'm Juliana with the Zakim Center, and this is Yogalates. So we're going to be working on our mat most of the time, and we usually use a couple of props like blocks, if you have a ball, a blanket, and a strap, things like that, just to support you. So if you need a support for your head, you can put a blanket. If you need extra padding under your mat, you can put a blanket there as well. The blocks and the balls are just to engage the core, and sometimes we work with that for the arms as well. So this is, again, like any other practice that we have here at the Zakim Center, this is your practice. You know your body better than anybody else, so feel free to change anything if you need to. So if there's anything that's bothering you, if you want to kick it up a notch and, you know, doing something a little bit more challenging, or going, you know, down and modifying, please do. Really listening to your body where it is today. That's the most important thing. All right. So with this, we're going to have some fun. So let's move to our mat. And I'm going to start seated today. And if it works for you, you know, maybe taking that blanket as you find your seat, just to give you a little bit more of a boost, just to find your seat here, feeling nice and tall. Now, if this feels like crossing your legs feels too much for your knees, you can always extend your legs out to the front, right? This is just a suggestion. Take your shoulders up to your ears, inhale, and exhale, roll them down the back. Again, inhaling up and exhaling down. Take one more like this. And exhaling down, take your hands along the side, drop your chin into your chest, inhale, roll left ear to the left shoulder, exhale, roll your chin into your chest, roll the right ear to the right shoulder. Start to loosen up on the neck and the shoulders. One more time, over to the left, exhale, chin into chest, roll it to the right, back to the center, hold it here, inhale, take your palms up to the sky, start to feel lift. Exhale, let's twist it over. Let the hands rest. Inhale, find a nice lift of the spine. Exhale, soften the belly and the shoulders. Perhaps you go a little deeper with the twist. Let the head maybe fall. Inhale and exhale. Keep your right hand where it is. Take your left arm up and over. Start to ground and start to open into the side body. Elbow can be bent or you can reach up. And then slowly release. Take those hands down slightly ahead of you. Tent the fingers. Inhale, open the heart. Now almost feeling like a cat that's pulling and draping and pulling the chest forward and through. And as you exhale, push your palms into the floor. Relax your head and round, and just giving a little nice stretch. Inhale, let your hands come up to your thighs. Open the chest. And exhale, gentle rounding of the spine. Circle your body. And then circle it the other way. All right, take those hands behind you. Switch the cross of your legs wherever is in front. And again, if your legs have to be extended, absolutely fine. Ground through the sit bones. Inhale, let your arms start to raise up, lift up. Exhale, let's twist to the other side. Let the hands land. With the inhale, you find some lift. Keep that length in your spine as you exhale. Perhaps you revolve a little bit more. Inhale one more time, think about lifting. Exhale, a gentle twist. Supporting the hand on the thigh. Take your right arm up and over. And again, you can always bend the elbows if you need. Maybe a little bit more pushing, softening, and opening ground through the sit bones. And exhale, soften and release. Take those fingertips down to the earth. And again, tent the fingers here. Like almost like a cat that's pulling into those drapes and opening the heart, pulling it up. Feel the chest lifting. Exhale, press into your palms, push it away, relax your head, spreading through the shoulder blades, soften it out, maybe a little wiggle of the body. Start to get a little bit more motion here, softening around. Walking your hands back up, roll your shoulders back. Nicely done. Take your hands behind you. Now this time, take your feet slightly ahead. I'm gonna just bring the blanket to the back edge of my mat. So from here, squeeze your elbows and start to find a little lifting of the sternum, of the chest. As you exhale, can you bend your elbows slightly back? Squeeze your elbows together and push up and lift up. Nice. So you're going to bend your elbows slightly back. Your spine is nice and long. Squeeze those elbows a little bit more together to press the palms and lift up. So you're doing a little tricep push-up. You bring it down a little bit more. Exhale, squeeze and lift. Bend the elbows. Think about the elbows squeezing together as you push up. Last two. Go down, control, belly pulls in, chest opens. Exhale up, last one, here we go. Push it up. Now hold it here in small pulses for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Relax it out, nicely done. Just relax your wrist, roll it around one side and then the other. Nice job, extend the arms. We're gonna stretch those triceps. So taking your left arm up and maybe you bring it behind your head. If you can find it there, you grab the elbow and maybe you find a little bit pushing it back and stretching to the side as well. And then you switch, do a little tap in the back. Already starting engaging here with the upper arms, the body, and bring it back down. Nicely done. Relax it out. I'm gonna shake out those legs. I'm gonna open it out to the side. Starting with a little bit of a mermaid here, engaging the core. One hand comes to the ankles, the other one to the side. And you're gonna inhale and slowly scoop your arm up and over. Get a little bit more into the side body. And as you exhale, release, bring that hand down. Take the other arm up and over. And slowly bring it all the way down. So your hands are gonna be here parallel to each other. Turn your chest and your nose to face forward. And from here, again, you're gonna bend your elbows, nose are gonna come down. And then as you exhale, you push it back up. And you bring it down. And then as you exhale, push it back up. So your elbows are bracing your body here. So it's a tricep and not a chest push-up. Last one. Nicely done. Take the arm up and over. And exhale, release. Take your hands behind you and switch in the position of your legs. Hold it here. Knees can be bent. If you need to extend those legs a little bit more, that's absolutely fine. I'm gonna hold it onto the side and start to get into the side body. A lot of side body this week. Exhale, slowly release. Bring that hand down. The other arm goes up and over. Nicely down. So your hands are gonna land. They're about the width of your shoulders. And now your elbows not going to the side, but going back closer to your ribs. You come down and you push up. You bring it down and you push up. Bring it down. Exhale, push it up. Last one. Nicely done. Take it back again. Let that arm release. Getting to the side. Take the hands behind you. Extend your legs out to the front. And from here, very gently roll yourself back, dropping to your elbows. And then maybe bringing the knees into your chest. If it feels better for you to roll to the side, you can. Now from here, I'm gonna take that blanket under the head. Get the knees into the chest. I'm just gonna start to roll the body. Roll the lower back. Moving the hips, the knees. And then take it to the other side. Really start to loosen up into the back, into the hips. And I'm gonna drop the left foot down. Keep the right knee into your chest. Hold it behind the right thigh. Now from here, if you prefer to use a strap, you can. I'm just kicking that leg up and down. Such a nice way to get into the knee joint, the hamstrings. Hold it up. Point flex the toe and roll the ankle. Point, flex, and roll it the other way around. All right, hold it here. Start to feel this really nice extension of the leg. Release your hands to the side. We're gonna create that pencil and four circles. You're gonna go small and you're starting to make it bigger. And two, and three, and four. So you're rotating from the hip crease and then slowly take it to the other side. So it's the hip joint here And you imagine that you're drawing circles up onto the ceiling, making your circles smaller for two and one. And then you're going to find that stability right there in the center. Hold it there. And from there, slowly start to lower the leg and then bring it back up. Flex the foot and start to lower about knee height. Point the toes, exhale, bring it up. And now it's like you're brushing and painting the wall slightly in front of you. Flex the foot, bring it down. Exhale, point it back up. Now I'm gonna start to lower it down a little bit more for these last four. Exhale, bring it back up. Last three. Last two. Last one, maybe hold it there, low without touching, and four, three, two, and one. And then just let that leg release, soften, extend the other leg, and just noticing the difference between the right and the left. Give a little bit of a shake, start to slide your right heel in, start to slide your left heel in, and your left knee comes into your chest, and you give it a hug. Hold it behind the thigh and start to extend and bend that knee. We start to warm up into your knee joint, into the hamstrings. Two more. Last one, hold it up there. Maybe pushing the thigh a little bit more into your hands, resisting and rolling the ankle to one side and move it around. And roll the ankle, flex and pointing the toes into the other side. All right, hold it here. Nice and tall. You're going to release your hands. Hands to the side. Now you're going to start to draw those small circles. And they're starting to get a little bit bigger. And you're moving from your hip socket. So the legs are straight. Three. And four. And now from the four, you're going to reverse. Four, from bigger to smaller, three, two, and one. And when you find that stability back there in the center, we're gonna start to lower the leg about knee height and then bring it back up. Knee height and back up. Now start to get a little bit more engaged. You're gonna flex the foot, exhale, point and bring it back up. Exhale, flex. Exhale, point it back up. Inhale, start to lower about knee height. Point the toes as you exhale, bring it up. And now maybe you start to going a little further down. You have four more. You can lower as low as you want. The lower you go, the harder it's gonna be. Exhale, back up. Inhaling down. Exhale, now you're like you're brushing and painting that wall diagonally across from you. This is your last one. We're gonna slowly lower it down. Take your time. And when it gets closer to the floor without touching, hold it there, maybe a little pulse for four, three, two, and one. And then slowly release that leg. Let the other leg also lands. And just noticing the right and the left, maybe a little shaking of the legs. And exhale, soften. Start to slide your heels back in. All right, I'm gonna grab the ball. And again, it can be a ball, it can be a block or a sweater, just something, a towel, just something that you could bring it between your knees and you're feeling a little bit more hugging of it. And it's gonna start to engage your inner legs. And we're gonna start to focus a little bit more on the pelvic floor here. Bring your hands, the heels of your palms here to your hip bones and having your fingers like a diamond. So your fingers are going to be pointing to your pubic bone and your thumbs are going to be pointing to your navel here. So if you let that hand rest there to the pelvis closer below, just below the navel, you're going to start to notice that maybe that, think about that as a ball, right? And now as you exhale, squeeze the ball a little bit, pull belly in, navel into spine, and notice how your lower back gets flat on the floor. Water will spill to your belly button. And as you inhale, allow the lower back to lift, to arch, and the water will spill between your legs. Exhale, squeeze the ball, pull belly in. Inhaling, moving forward. Exhale, squeeze navel into spine, lower back gets flat. Glute starts to get engaged. Inhale, relaxing. Exhale, squeezing. Inhale, relaxing and lifting. Water between the legs. Exhale, squeezing, navel pulling in, lower back gets flat. Pelvic floor starts to get engaged. You have three more. Exhale. Two more. This is such a great exercise to release tension in the lower back, sciatic pain. Last one. Now try to find that neutral spine where the water is staying still. It's not shifting back and forth. That means that you might have that natural curve on your lower back. And just thinking about going side to side, one hip gets a little higher than the other. Side to side, just a small movement. Right hip gets a little bit higher, then the left hip gets a little bit higher. And now we're gonna try to create those pelvic locks. We're gonna feel like if there's a dial, it's gonna be pointing in any direction that you're dipping, or if you had a marble onto that bowl, it would just drop to 12 o'clock, and then you rotate it to 3 o'clock. And then it's to 6, navel into spine, and then to 9, and then to 12 again between the legs. And do it that one more time. 3, 6, 9, and 12. Last time through. 3, 6, 9, and 12. Now reverse. 9, 6, 3, and 12. And you might even start to notice that one side feels a little easier than the other. Last time through, 12, 9, 6, and 3. And then finding that stability back into the center. All right, so we did a lot of movement here with the pelvis, you know, back and forth, side to side. We're gonna take our hands and work onto the breathing, the rib cage breathing. So this is important so that when you breathe into the side ribs, into the back, you're not puffing your ribs up. So you're not lifting up and arching, but you're keeping the core engaged and you're still being able to breathe into those side ribs, into the back without expanding up, right? So that is the engagement of the core, the spine, neutral position. If you take your hands to the side and hold onto your ribs, inhale into your hands, and exhale it out. Feel the navel pulling in, the air moving away. Inhale into your hands. Exhale it out. If it feels uncomfortable to bring the hands to the side, you can always cross your hands in front and hold the side over the body. Just noticing which one feels better for you. If crossing, you're breathing into your fingers, feeling them separating, and then exhale, softening. Or to the side, inhale. Side and back breath, exhale. Navel into the spine, the air moves out. One more, inhale. And exhale. So we're gonna try to keep that breathing, that rib cage breathing. So you're not puffing those ribs up and down and you're controlling your core, your deep ab muscles. I'm gonna take the heels of the palms to the crease of the hips, a gentle squeeze into the ball. And as you exhale, pull belly in, empty it from the front, pelvic floor engages and you push into your thighs. Inhale, relax. And think about taking the breath to those side ribs into the back. Exhale, push into the thighs. Squeeze the ball, pull belly in. Navel into spine, pelvic floor engages. You might even lift your tail maybe half an inch from the floor. Inhale, relax, breathe into the side. Exhale, empty it from the front. Push into the thighs. Last time through, inhale. this is starting to engage your really deep ab muscles. Exhale, squeeze. And then relax. Nicely done. So that's starting to engage that the pelvic floor. And from here, we're going to start to add a little bit more. So I'm going to take I'm going to keep the ball there actually. And I'm going to find a block. So with the block here, I'm going to start to bend my elbows. I'm going to bend. I'm going to extend. I'm going to exhale, bend. And I'm going to inhale, extend. I'm going to exhale, bend. So the block comes kind of closer to my head and I extend. Bending onto your elbows only and pushing it back up. Press into the block and fingertips up. Press, keep your elbows parallel. And three more. Two more. Last one. Hold it here. We're gonna bend those elbows. Keep your elbows parallel to each other, like they're also squeezing a block between them. And you're gonna take your block behind your head. And then you take your elbows in. So you start to work also side body lats, working a little bit of triceps as you pull. You take it back, inhale. Exhale, pull it in. Inhale. Exhale, pull it in. You have four more. Over the head. Elbows stay bent the entire time. Two more. Exhale, pull it in. Pelvic floor is still engaged, core engaged. Last one. Nicely done. Let go. Take your right arm across the body. Hold below or above the elbow. Relax the wrist. Roll it out. Let the head look over to the right. And take the arms back up. Cross your left arm in front. Hold below or above the elbow. Roll the wrist and you look over your shoulder. All right. Take the arms back up. Hold it here. They're facing each other. Now, if you have small weights and you like to hold your weights, you can do that. Or you just can stay with the arms here and you're gonna go scissor your arms. One arm goes back, the other one goes forward, you come back up. And then you go to the other side. Now, as you're doing this, be aware of your core, belly's pulling in, lower back is engaged. You're gentle squeezing the block so you're not letting your lower back arch. The arms don't have to touch the floor. You're going at your own range of motion. Inhaling, exhaling. Feel the inhale, bringing those arms up. Exhaling as you reach in opposite directions. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, and exhaling. Last one. You're gonna stop with those arms right over the head. Hold it here. You start to open your arms out to the side. And exhale, close your elbows parallel. Open out to the side. And close it in. Out. You close your elbows bent like a cactus arm, 90 degree. Doesn't have to let the arms touch the floor. You close it in, working into the chest, back body. Last two. Last one. Nicely done. Let your palms come to the floor. Move your hips. All right, we're going to take this a little bit more. We're going to take those feet off the floor. Now, noticing that if you bring your knees into your chest, it feels really kind of like easy for your lower back to stay on the floor, right? When you start to move your knees right over your hips, noticing how your lower back wants to arch, you have to engage your core to stabilize. This is where the work is, right? With the knees right over the hips. Stay here. Palms are onto the floor. Be aware of what's going on with your shoulders. Keep it there. Inhale. And as you exhale, slowly start to drop your knees to one side. Inhale here as you pause, you notice. And exhale, you bring it back up. Inhale, engage your core. Navel pulls in. And exhale, you drop it to the other side. Doesn't have to be too much. You inhale, you pause. You exhale, you come back up again. Inhale here. Exhale, drop it to one side. Now, the further you drop it, the harder it gets. You inhale, you pause, you exhale, you come back. Inhale, engage. Exhale, you drop. Inhale, you pause. Exhale, you come back up. Two more, inhale. Exhale. Inhale, notice in the pause, don't let the knees touch the floor. Exhale, you come back up. Inhale, engage. Exhale, lower. Pause, inhale, engage. Exhale, come back up. Hold it here. Take your hands to your thighs. Push your hands against the thighs, thighs against the hand, engage the core. Hold it. Take one more breath in. Inhale into the side, into the back. Exhale, feel the resistance as you squeeze the block. Push your hands into the thighs into the hands. Navel's pulling in, lower back is getting flat. Inhale one more time. If this feels too much, just drop your feet to the floor, just like we did on the first one. This is your last one. Exhale, push. And then relax. Take your knees into your chest. Take the ball out of the way. From here, you circle your knees in one direction. Start to massage your lower back. And then circle your knees the other way. Nicely done. All right. We're going to keep that left foot down to the floor. Take the right leg up again. And cross the right ankle over the left thigh. Hold it here. And you start to move your hips a little side to side. And we're going to keep that left foot there. Just let the right knee move away. Take your left hand and bring it behind your head. And just let the arm stay there, the elbow to the side. Right hand is onto the floor. And as you inhale here, noticing the back. As you exhale, pull belly in, and perhaps you lift your head up. Now try to keep your head resting onto your hand. Chin a little bit into the chest. There's a little bit of space between the chin and the chest. As you exhale, maybe the head will come up, and inhale, coming down. Now if this feels too much, keep the head down and then start to take the elbow to the side and opening. If you can, start to take the elbow up and down. So you start to twist from your left shoulder and down. Two more and down. Let the head be supported. One and down. Relax it here. Keep that 90 degree angle. And then maybe pick up your left foot. If you feel that you want more, you thread your hands between the legs and you start to get into your outer hips. Inhale. And maybe with your next exhale, you start to rock the little side to side. Staying with your figure four here, rolling the ankle and then to the other side. We're gonna start to drop our knees to the left. So when you feel ready for you, let it all drop to the left. You can hold onto your ankle if you like. If this feels too much, stack the knees or even put a block between it. Let your right shoulder open to the right. Let the head move a little side to side so you start to soften the neck, the shoulders. And you start to notice the side body stretch here. Maybe you keep that elbow bent. Maybe you let the head open a little bit more to the right. Now from here, we're gonna stack those knees, one on top of the other. The right arm is gonna come up and over your head like you're brushing the floor with your fingertips. And it comes all the way to the side. So you're coming into a windmill, and then we're gonna take those fingertips and start to take it over. The elbow can be bent, the arm could be a little bit more extended, and then you open. And then one more time, you're gonna reverse. Now, as you come back to the center, hold it here. One palm on top of the other. Inhale, let the right fingertips go up. And exhale, you close. Inhale up. And exhale, you close. Then we're going to take a two-part breath. If that works for you, you're going to go inhale and exhale. Doesn't have to touch the floor. Inhale and exhale. On this one, You're going to let that arm drop back. Exhale, softening like there's a little balloon. The air is just coming out of it and it slowly floats down. The arm can be more parallel. It can be as the T. Finding the opening here. Cactus arms with the elbow bent, fingers reaching back is definitely the biggest stretch. And as you exhale, slowly bring yourself back in, holding that right knee, extending the left leg. Just let it extend. And as you exhale, you switch. Hold the other knee, extend the other leg. And as you exhale, you switch. Now you can keep your head and shoulders on the floor and exhale, you switch. If you feel that you want to start to add a little bit more, you start to pick up the chin into chest, shoulders off the floor. Again, if this bothers your back, the neck, come back down, right? Everybody is in a different level. Everybody's in a different place. You know your body better than anybody else. And next time, both knees into the chest and hold. Let the feet come down to the earth. Take a ball and bring it between your knees. And when you feel ready, heels are not too far away. Squeeze the ball, pull belly in, and start to very gently lifting the hips slightly off the floor and then lower. Exhale, squeeze, gentle pelvic floor engagement. Inner leg starts to engage and lower. Two more. Start to engage the glutes, activate the inner legs and lower. Exhale, squeeze, navel pulls in, glutes engage, inner legs, knees are reaching to the front of the room. Imagine somebody's grabbing behind and bring it back down. Excellent work. Just taking the ball to the side, give your knees a hug. Gentle rock here. And now as you're going to drop your right foot and take your left ankle on top. And from here, open your arm to the side. Just let your body do a little wiggle side to side here. Just noticing that figure four, bring your right hand behind. And again, you can just maybe hold behind the head and just finding a little lift, chin to chest. Could be very small. Some of you start to turn a little bit more. You have four more. Exhale, three. Exhale, two. And one. Let it come back down. Give your knees a hug. Maybe starting to slide the hands behind the thigh, between the legs, under the right thigh, or maybe start to bring it even more to get deeper into your glutes. Again, it's your choice. Whatever feels more comfortable here for you. Gentle rocking of the body. And then from here, we're gonna drop this over to the side. You can hold onto your ankle. You can let your hand open out. You can let your head drop. And you start to soften. You start to breathe a little bit more into the side body. If you want more, with arms, it will start to reach back a little bit more like a cactus arms. Just noticing the breath. If you need to change anything, soften it up. Head just opens a little bit more side to side. Now you're going to let your arm come up and over your head. Stack your knees. Stack the arms. And from here, we're going to slowly open it up. And you're going to brush your fingers onto the floor like a dial. Inhaling up and over, creating this little halo windmill, and all the way up. Next time the arms are parallel to each other over to the left, you're going to take your left fingertips up. And as you exhale, you close. Inhaling and exhaling. Now taking is a two-part breath. You're going to inhale, take it up. Exhale, you start to open. So maybe noticing with the inhale up with the knees together, and the body fully to one side. How does that feel? This time you're going to let it go all the way back, like there's a little balloon there, letting the air dropping. Any position, so if the more parallel to your body, with if you're having more scar tissue, or if you need to open it more, or even all the way up. Just be mindful how the knees feel. And with your next exhale, slowly bring yourself back to the side. Give your left knee a hug, and extend your right leg out. And as you exhale, perhaps you switch. And as you exhale, perhaps you switch. If you want to add more, chin into chest, and the head might come off the floor. If this feels too much, let it stay down. Now I'm going to start to add a little bit more. I'm going to extend that leg up and switch and switch and switch. So bringing your hands behind the leg. If you want to add more, you take your head and shoulder off the floor. If that feels too much for you, drop it down. We have two and one. Bring your knees into your chest. Give it a nice hug and rock. Excellent work. We're going to drop the feet back down. And again, finding that ball. Engage your glutes, quads, lift it up. And lower. Four. And lower. Exhale, squeeze. Three. And lower. Two. And lower. Last one. Hold it up. Give it a little squeeze and tuck. And four. Three. Pulse it. Two. One. Are you going to pulse it out? If the ball falls, that's absolutely fine. That's what we're hoping for. And pulse it. Four. Three. Two. And one. Take the ball from under you so when you return, it doesn't smash, and you give your knees a hug once again. Gentle rock here. And we're going to roll it over to one side and allow your elbows or your arms to support you. Now, again, you can stay on your hand. You can lay all the way down or support here. Wherever you are, you want to imagine there's like something supported on your shoulders. So you're not moving the shoulders. It's stacked. Bottom leg is bent and the top leg is extended. You're going to take it up and down, up and down. Four, three, two. I missed my count. Two more and two. There we go. And one, hold it. Small circle, point the toes. Four, three, two, one. Small circles to the other side. Four, three, two, one. Nicely done. Now we're going to take that leg down. I'm going to bring it in front today and hold it onto the ankle. Now again, if this feels too much, bring the foot behind you and come up onto your elbows. If you have it here, lift the bottom leg. You point the toes down and take the heel up, you might find it a little bit more interesting, meaning you're going to feel it more. We have six now. Five, four, three, two, and one. Now bend that leg again, take the other leg out, and from here again, supporting yourself all the way down. Think about a big bicycle, so the knee comes in and extends out and it sweeps back and it bends and it sweeps and it bends and it sweeps. This is your last one. Big bicycle wheel. And then bring yourself back to the center and hold it here. Turn yourself down to your belly. Finding a little bit of a sphinx, your elbows are slightly ahead. You feel that they're pushing down into the floor and pulling into your body. So it opens your chest, your collarbones forward. Stay with this. Nice long spine, relax the head a little bit. And then taking the right foot, kick, kick, point, and bring it down. Flex the left foot, kick, kick, point, and bring it down. You flex, kick, kick, point, and bring it down. You flex, kick, kick, point, and bring it down. Flex, kick, kick, point, and bring it down. Three, flex, flex, point, bring it down. Two, flex, point, and bring it down. Last one, point, and bring it down. So engage in your hamstrings. Start to feel the elbows, chest opening. Let the arms move out to the side, perhaps. Relax the head, forehead down. You can even take the edge of the blanket here. And maybe the right arm slightly comes up, left arm. Feel the toes reaching back. Squeeze your elbows. Maybe the chest lifts a little bit and then hovers. Take the arms out to the side like a field goal position. Chin is down, gaze is down. Maybe squeeze your elbows, pull the chest a little forward. And then relax. Last one. Feel the arms just hovering from the floor like a field goal position. And then maybe squeeze your elbows. Feel the crown of the head reaching forward. And then release. Take your hands down. And bring yourself into a tabletop, a cat-cow of the spine. And I'm just going to turn it around so I can turn it to the other side so I don't turn my back to you. And then I'm going to lay back down onto the side. Let the arm come out, elbow, wherever you had. This is our final series. So from here, you're going to take it up and down. Up and down. We have six. Hips are stacked, shoulders are stacked. Five. Four. Three. Unfortunately, second side always feels more. Two. Because you already use that leg to stabilize. One. All right, hold it up there and small circles for four, three, two, and one. And to the other side for four, three, two, and one. Great job. I'm going to take that foot in front. I'm going to hold on to that ankle. If you prefer to lay all the way down, you can. And we're going to take the top leg up and down. We have six, five, four, three, two, and one. Excellent work. Just take it back. Little pulse. Four, three, two, one. Release it down. Bend that knee again. Extend the leg. And again, bend the knee in. Goes forward. Extend. Flex the foot and take it back. Bend it in, point, flex, and sweep it back. Two more, big wheel. Last one. Excellent work, nicely done. Turn yourself back to face the ceiling just to get a nice release here. Relax the shoulders, turn your palms up. Stretch it out and taking the left ankle over the thigh, getting a figure four stretch so you can stretch into your glutes. We did a lot of work there. Bring the hands under, roll the ankle, let the head soften. Maybe a wiggling of the body. And then take it to the other side, other cross. Head crosses in front and on top. And you rock it here a little side to side. Nicely done. And then we're going to turn it around. Take your time. So when you find yourself down onto your belly, spine is nice and long once again. Relax the head. Open the heart. Think about more length than height. Feel the chest, collarbones opening forward, the shoulders moving away from the ears, the toes reaching back. And as you exhale, slowly start to slide your hands closer to your body. Push yourself up to your tabletop. Take your time to find it. A little cat and cow of the spine. And again, It could be very small, especially if you tend to have lower back issues. So don't exaggerate the dump into your cow, right? Because it's that dumping into the cow here that usually causes a lot of lower back issues. So pulling that navel in to stabilize a little bit more. Take the hands over to the right. Push a little bit more to the left and, oh, sorry. Reach more with the left and push more with the right. Relax the head and then take it over to the other side. Let me form a way here that works for you. Let the head soften, maybe moving the hips. Bring it back to the center and just changing the position of your hands so you can get some stretch from your wrist. Pressing the palm down. Reversing, peeling that elbow in the direction of your body. Maybe pushing the hips back. And then taking it to the other side. Fingers face in, thumbs out. Elbow is bending in the direction of your body. Give it a little shake here, move it around. And then from here, return to your seat. Perhaps you find that blanket or blocks under your hips just to find a little bit more of lifting engagement here. Roll those shoulders. Inhale, let the arms reach up. Now again, the legs can always be extended forward. Exhale, twist. Inhale, lengthen to the spine. Exhale, find a little bit, release into the back. Keep the right hand where it is, left arm is just up and over. Similar to the way we started. Inhale, take both arms up. Exhale, twist to the other side. Find the support that you need. Exhale, maybe going a little deeper with a twist. Stay with the left hand where it is, right arm goes up and over. Let that arm pull you back up. Inhale, both arms up. Exhale, roll your wrists all the way down. Excellent work. Inhale, hands to your heart. And just bowing for all the great work that you did today. Thank you so much for joining me today. If you have any questions, doubts, feedback, let me know. Otherwise, I'll see you around. Be well, guys.